This is not my beautiful house of dead ninjas. This is not my beautiful shuriken of decapitation. Oh wait, yes it is. Hi, I'm Duke of the Bump. So, I learned a couple things about this game since the last time I played. Let's see, do I want to stick with the whip or do I want to go back to the katana? Let's try the katana again, see if I like it better than the whip, I'm not sure. Definitely don't want that crap. And everything else looks good. Alright, so, I asked in one of the previous videos if there was actually a reason to start at one of these previous levels, and someone mentioned that when you're playing on normal, it's basically like practice mode for the real thing, which is hard, and on hard mode, you have to start from the roof every time. So, it's kind of like in Spelunky, where, like, for a run to really count, it has to start from the beginning. I mean, there's no, like, mechanic for that, but, you know, it's sort of similar to that. So, basically, by not playing from the roof every time, I'm not getting the practice I need to eventually play the game on hard, which, you know, I'll get to that. I'd like to see the quote-unquote end of the game first, or at least the end of this segment of the game. So I will start in the Royal Sanctum. So one of the things I learned about this game is that there is a super jump, and I was sort of on the right track. The problem with the super jump is that if you don't have the head clearance to do it, it won't even charge the jump up, which is why I was confused in the last few videos. Let me get some headroom here. And see, since I actually have room to make the jump, I can charge it up. So, that should come in handy, especially for getting some of those hard-to-reach items. That was a close one. Right, another thing I learned is that when you talk to the ghosts that give you advice and stuff, the timer actually stops, and I've sort of been skipping those guys because I was so, you know, focused on my timer. So once I come across another one of those guys, I should be able to actually sit and read what they have to say, and hopefully it'll be helpful. Okay, another thing I learned is that when you are in, when you're in rage mode, you're actually invincible. And I knew you were super fast and you did more damage, but I didn't realize you were invincible when you enter rage mode. So I will have to remember that in the future. Because if you're invincible, then you can just, you know, dash through and just go nuts, killing enemies to try to keep it going as long as possible. I didn't learn to do the crawl jump here, or the crawl walk apparently. So, that last run, where I made it to the extremely large enemy, I still have no idea if that was actually the last boss or not. I hit the bomb button by mistake. I mean, it sure looked like last boss material, but I am not sure. I want those crates. Oh, bull honky, the freaking scorpion thing hit me. Alright, hopefully I will get to that boss again in this playthrough. I won't make any promises that I will be able to defeat that boss, but I will at least try to do a little better. One thing I've sort of, I mean, I learned this early on, but I just recently started applying this information, is that if you are running towards an enemy from behind, when you attack with a sword, it does like a little decapitation move, and I think that gives you more rage in your rage meter. And like that guy, normally he takes two hits to take out, but it was, I guess it's like a sneak attack would be the closest approximation. So you get a little more damage for it. How do I open this? That like background or something? Does it have something to do with this enemy? Amazing. Well, destroying that didn't open that chest, so I'm not sure what the deal with that is. Crap! Where the heck did that thing come from? Nowhere, that's where. Well, I guess you have to... You can't wait around on that super jump. Wow, I'm surprised I got that without taking damage and getting that totally pointless. Oh, sweet. So not only does that stop the timer, it's like resetting it back to 30 as well. Excellent. What is that? Oh yeah, monkey bed. That stuff's pretty good. I guess these chests are just cosmetic. Kind of like the piles of gold and stuff. I don't know if the decapitation move works with like these animal style enemies, or if it only works with humanoid enemies. Because it would be kind of weird to decapitate like a pink elephant thing, or whatever that is. A pink rhinocetops. Great! Bustle out of nowhere. My favorite kind. Really love his tone of voice when he says magic. Crap. I don't know, there are definitely things I like about the katana more than the whip. But I think the whip might be more useful, like, overall. See, if I had the whip, I could get that. Let's just blow out these spikes. Even though my shurikens are almost full. Screw it. I hit that attack button. You dork. That's cool, I kind of batted the bomb away. Didn't realize I could do that. Heck is this? Oh, I guess it's just a barrier that was not protecting anything. Interesting. Need to start doing that attack more. That's a pretty useful attack, it seems like. Alright, I used all my continues, right? So I'm gonna have to defeat the one-armed ninja again, probably. Hentai. Yeah. Did you just say hentai? Ow! Oh, I can't even shuriken him when he's flashing? That's bogus. Alright, so the bombs don't seem to hurt me unless I'm actually blown up by them. Like, just touching them, even though they're spiky, looks like I can sort of run through them. Alright, out of continues. Well, I'm a little rusty. I haven't played this game in a while, so that was probably to be expected. Didn't unlock anything for that one. Alright, well. Get back on the horse. probably should have switched back to the whip. But, I'll try the shuriken a little bit. Or the katana, rather. I'm raging, that means I'm invincible. So is that invincible to enemies? Or I guess it's invincible to everything. And just jump right through those spikes. That's pretty cool. Oh, my rage ran out. Oh hey, apple saucers. It's that guy. Or lady. Man, y'all suck. Oh, bullcrap! I just wanted to make sure there was nothing up there. Oh, man. And I didn't seem to run into any monkeys when I actually had the monkey bane. Maybe that's the whole point of it. Maybe they don't even show up when you have the monkey bane. Pretty nice. I thought that would have been a what? Oh right, this thing. God damn it. Man, these enemies are tricky. Alright, let's keep going. Ooh, I want that stuff. Alright, so now I know. Oh wait, I guess I still need to bomb that, don't I? I guess I might have screwed that up. Yeah, there's no way to set a bomb down there now. Oh well. Too much lollygagging. Phew! I wonder if that crate's still there. Probably not. I think the items disappear if you go too far past them. Oh, still there. Nice. I don't know why I can't. Well, I spent entirely too much time trying to get that crap. Jesus. Wonder if I can outrun. Oh. Well, I took a hit anyway, so... God! This is not a good run. I'll be the first to admit. I've definitely had better. I always forget that the shuriken can kind of... Go over these one block barriers like that. It looks like they would block the shuriken, but I have to remember that it will not. Crap, I didn't mean to hit down there. Oh, that's one of those skull pickups. I don't know what that does, but I know I don't want it. Nice! X-ray specs. It's a pretty useful item. I always think these things are going to hurt me, but it doesn't look like they do. Apparently you have to hit that thing in the eye. I did not know that. Crap! No! I didn't mean to fall down there. This run is garbage. I should be ashamed of myself. The hell? Oh. Right, so yeah, the clock stops. Yeah, that is true. I just really don't like the range on those nunchucks. Oh yeah, I got a Steam trading card. I guess that's one good thing that'll come from playing this. Nah, that's not true. I'm having fun. I'm just mad because I'm sucking today. Oh, well, I'm not using the keyboard, but I guess that would work with the, Hey, yep, it does work with my bomb button. Alright, I have one hit point and no continues, I think, so this is probably not going to go well. Alright, that run was atrocious. I have to give it one more shot. Let's see what item I unlocked. Mm-hmm. It's a new weapon. Oh, it's a new kind of bomb. Play the game 10 times to get this explosive thingy. Explodes after it comes to rest. Oh. Is that annoying for me or annoying for them? Well, I guess I have to at least try it. See how differently it plays. I mean, they all kind of have a delay on them, like the normal bombs do as well. So I'm not really sure what the deal is going to be. Yep. Bullcrap. Well, I unlocked the life power up. I guess for dying a certain number of times. Bull. Shit, I hit you with my sword. Okay, yeah, that is pretty annoying. I don't know why anyone would use that. Jeez. I mean, especially since I have such a limited amount of time. Well, that one blew up. Oh, is it like random or something? Is it like a random timer? Because that one blew up immediately. Or maybe it just blows up immediately, like if it hits something. I was gonna go back for that money, but screw it. Just points. I mean, I'm sure there are unlocks I can get by getting enough points, but I have more pressing things to worry about. Like actually getting to this boss again. Come on, health. What's that? Oh, just a bunch of points, I guess. Alright. Get psyched. That was close. That was probably too close. Such skill. Audacious. Time. In your face. Bull. Right, so it looks like I can do my downward slash on those spiky things. And I have a second before I have to worry about the spikes popping out. I And these grenades seem bouncier than the other kind too. See, that was a decapitation. So was that. You have to be careful though, because like if you don't have enough forward momentum, I don't think you're gonna get it. Like you kinda have to be running full speed. Nice! Come on, give me something to kill. Yeah! I wonder if talking to the ghost also pauses my my rage timer. Or if it's just a normal timer. Probably just a normal timer. I'll draw some magic and I can't get to it. Oh well. That's a pretty effective period of rage, I think. Aw, I had rage for like a split second, and then I lost it. Bull! Man, this is a hard jump to make. Jeez. When you can pull it off, it's pretty dope though. Yep, figured that one out. But thank you. Maybe I should just bomb those spike traps when I doubt my ability to make the jump. Should've waited. Alright, last continue. Eventually, I want to collect enough letters that I can at least formulate a hypothesis as to what collecting those do. What collecting those does. Right, 4 hit points left, no continues. Probably not going to go well for me, but I will try. I'm pretty sure it says hentai there, which is kind of weird. What the fuck? Man, I didn't have this much trouble with this guy last time. See, your instinct is to just run at him full speed. And you can't really do that. Oops. Because you still get hit. Alright, well, I unlocked more life at least, so that wasn't a totally pointless run. Let's see what else I got. Yep, only one more life upgrade to go. And I got... collecting this... ooh! That's a pretty good one. Automatically go into rage mode. Alright, well, this has been some pretty bad attempts. Tune in tomorrow for hopefully better attempts. Bye.